This is Reflection for Sunday, November 20th. This week in Danville, all other news was overshadowed by the untimely death of Jim Crawford. This is Reflection, a WBTM award-winning news presentation highlighting the week's local news events. Reflection is brought to you by Tamson Chevrolet of Danville. Your commentator is Bill Schwarz. In 60 seconds, Reflection.
Give a shout, give a cheer, you can make the deal of the year on a Chevrolet at Tamson. Chevrolet.
Would you believe you could own a brand new 1967 Chevrolet Impala for just $55 a month? Prices on 67 Chevys are unbelievable at Tamson Chevrolet, and that's what made Tamson Southside Virginia's largest dealer. Low prices and generous trades. So why not own a new 67 Impala two-door hardtop sport coupe? An $800 trade-in or down payment will leave you monthly payments of just $55 a month. Or trade for any other new 1967 Chevy of your choice at equally low prices. Stop in this week and pick out the Chevy you want. Hundreds ready for immediate delivery. The place, Tamson Chevrolet. Open daily from 10 a.m. till 9 p.m. at 1063 Riverside Drive in Danville. Tamson Chevrolet, Southside Virginia's volume dealer.
WBTM General Manager and Corporation President James H. Crawford died early Wednesday morning at Memorial Hospital. His loss is felt keenly both within and outside the organization. Thursday morning, Corporation Vice President and News Director Leon Smith issued the following editorial.
A WBTM editorial. There comes a time in personal associations, in business relationships, and in social intermingling when the firm, unrelenting hand of death calls a halt on many fronts, leaves a void which seems at the moment can never be filled. It seemed hopefully, though against tremendous odds, that Jim Crawford's spirit had spelled victory over the weakness of his physical body, but it wasn't to be. James H. Crawford, general manager of WBTM Radio and president of Piedmont Broadcasting Corporation, died as other strong men before him have, and after far too few years of living and giving. He passed mercifully into a coma last night, and as his active mind ceased to function in sleep, was oblivious of his losing that which for years he had been determined to keep. Jim Crawford was possessed of a brand of courage, born of his own determination and high ambition. Not many among us have it, else we would all be kings. Those of us who have worked closely with Jim Crawford over the years have many times come face to face with our own inability to cope on an equal footing. He was possessed of a tremendous drive that knew no quarter, stood for little relaxation, and gave little room for compromise. In retrospect, and in light of his falling to forces far removed from his own doing, Jim's adult life stands on the record book as a sure sign of pointing to achievement. He knew his time was limited, but even knowledge so devastating failed utterly to dampen his spirit. As it's been with others before him, the strength that was Jim Crawford's, the determination and relentless drive, was not attributed to other men and women outside his own sphere. For the weak, there was charity. For the poor, there was sustenance. And for the unacceptable, acceptance. And despite his seriousness of purpose, the man's life was sparked by a love of humor, though he himself was impatient with his inability to deliver his share. Jim Crawford was affectionate, was content in the company of a multitude of people, but reserved his love in the form of a fiery devotion to his own and to those very close to him. His absence will be sorely felt until the healing power of time dims the remembrance of how it used to be. Gone from the air in the early morning are the admonitions that today's a good day. Gone from the municipality is one of the strong advocates of good progressive government. Gone from his church is the strength of his support in word and in deed. And gone from his chosen work is the strongest influence for good radio the Danville area has ever seen. The lines of communication have been severed. That's our comment for Piedmont Broadcasting Corporation and Jim Crawford, Leon Smith, WBTM News.
At a noon meeting of City Council Thursday, Mayor W.C. McCubbins, as he called the meeting to order, said, "Gentlemen, Danville has lost a good friend. Join me in a moment of silence in memory of Jim Crawford." There followed an invocation by City Manager T. Edward Temple. At the same moment, a minute of silence was observed simultaneously on both WBTM and WDVA after Ned Richardson made this statement.
The Board of Directors of Piedmont Broadcasting Corporation, Mr. W. E. Gardner, Jr., Chairman, the Board's Executive Committee, and the staff of WBTM Radio, ask that you join with us now in a tribute to James H. Crawford, General Manager and President of the Corporation, who died last night. Please join us for a moment of silent meditation, following which we will have a brief memorial from Dr. Howard W. Lee, pastor of West Main Baptist Church.
This is Howard Lee in the pastor's study, and I come to share with you today the sorrow in Jim's parting. The words are deliberately chosen. Those of us who listened to him day by day did not know him as Mr. Crawford, nor as radio executive. We knew him as a friend who was allowed to share with us the intimacy of our own homes by way of radio. There will be many tributes paid to him as community leader, as a leader in the radio industry. There will be tributes to him because I know him to be a churchman, and I know him to be a family man. But I want to take a moment to pay tribute to him as a man of moral conviction. Those of us ministers who faced him across the microphone and who grappled on the pastor's study with moral issues knew that this was not just play acting with him. For often when the microphone was shut off, the discussion of moral issues went on. And as his pastor, I know how he struggled where moral issues were involved, as he asked the question, "What does God expect me to do in this situation and in that?" It was not an idle question with him. It was a serious question. And often by sweat and tears did he reach decisions where he thought moral issues were involved and he grappled with them. I do not mean to imply that this is a perfect man. He was a sinner saved by grace. He was a friend who talked with us and battled life with us and lived it as we lived it. And now God has called him to a higher reward. He was sent, however, to say, as no minister can say it, that there are moral and spiritual issues involved in life. He did not hold himself up as the perfect example of what all moral things ought to be, but he grappled with moral issues. and called a community to grapple with them. This impact, we trust, will continue on his industry and on his community. For more eloquently than any words of the preachers, this layman has proclaimed that there are moral issues to live by, and there are spiritual convictions which men must note. Being a preacher, I have liberties that others do not, and therefore I ask you to join me in a simple prayer. Gracious God, we thank thee for the gift of this man's life. What was so very good about it, we pray, shall remain within our hearts and within our community. Take away from it the dross, separating the chaff from the wheat, and allowing to be distilled in all of us those things which thou hast placed in him and we trust in us. In the name of Christ Jesus our Lord, and for the glory of our God. Amen.
The Thursday afternoon edition of the Danville Bee contained the following editorial. To be completely honest, a lot of people said James H. Crawford talked too much. And it's true that he was ready with the words the minute a microphone switch was thrown, or at the rap of a gavel opening the countless meetings he attended. Jim Crawford even laughed about it himself. From the time he arrived in Danville from North Carolina until the final seizure of his fatal illness, Jim Crawford had a vast following as a radio personality. Even when he became president and general manager of the Piedmont Broadcasting Corporation, he insisted on doing his turn in front of the open microphone, cheerfully chatting or making a sincerely emotional appeal for some worthy cause. Jim Crawford was more than a radio personality. He plunged himself into civic activities at all levels, promoting religion, schools, decency, and a better way of life. He was concerned about and a champion of our young people, and he sought to bring cheer to the ailing and the elderly. With him, talking was more than a livelihood. It was an essential part of his life. His words and his acts reflected a sensitivity rare in these times. Jim Crawford talked a lot. After all, he had a lot to say and little time in which to say it. The loss to the industry of this dynamic man was felt across the nation. Even national news commentator Paul Harvey was moved to comment on his program Friday.
This week cost our industry more than it can afford. They'll bury Jim Crawford today in Danville, Virginia. Few knew the brilliant young president of Piedmont Broadcasting had leukemia, was doomed to die at 38.
By unanimous resolution on the part of Danville City Council in a special meeting Thursday, the governing body agreed that City Attorney James A.H. Ferguson be authorized to prepare a resolution of condolence for the family of Jim Crawford, deceased. Crawford, general manager of WBTM, died at Memorial Hospital 11 hours previous to the noon meeting of Danville's governing body. Friday, City Attorney Ferguson completed the resolution in memory of James Hewell Crawford, Jr. It reads, that whereas on November 17, 1966, the city of Danville suffered a great loss in the passing of an outstanding leader and citizen, James Hewell Crawford, Jr. And that whereas Jim Crawford served his community unselfishly and untiringly, being an active participant in his church as well as in various civic and benevolent organizations, and that whereas he ably served as a member of the school board of the city of Danville and gave freely of his time to this endeavor, and that whereas in his professional capacity as president and general manager of Piedmont Broadcasting Corporation, radio station WBTM has become a leader in its field, and that whereas as a result of his many charitable, religious, and civic pursuits, he received in 1959 the award of the Junior Chamber of Commerce as Danville's outstanding young citizen. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Council of the City of Danville that we do hereby pause in respect to the memory of James Hewell Crawford, Jr., hereby record our sense of loss and express our deepest sympathy to his bereaved family. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be sent to his family and a copy recorded in the minutes of council for posterity. James H. Crawford was laid to rest in Mountain View Cemetery in Danville Friday, following afternoon services in West Main Baptist Church, with Dr. Howard W. Lee officiating. The service at the church and the cemetery was of a simple nature. Dr. Lee mentioned the brevity of his eulogy and the reading of the scriptures as following the spiritual concepts of the deceased and of the family. The church sanctuary reached its capacity long before the service started at 2 o'clock, and many mourners for the late radio personality went directly to the cemetery for the interment service which followed. Because of the expressed desire of friends of Jim Crawford's who could not attend the services, his station, WBTM, broadcast the service from the church. Many friends of Jim's in the industry came to Danville for the funeral, and members of the staff of WBTM Radio attended in a body. Jim Crawford loved Danville, and he loved WBTM. His entire being was directed toward the betterment of both. What Jim said of WBTM can also be said of him. In his own words,
WBTM Radio, first to care, first to serve, first to inform.
You've been listening to Reflection. This is Bill Schwarz, WBTM News.
Reflection is a production of WBTM News, presented as a courtesy of Tamson Chevrolet. This is Phil Watlington speaking. This is WBTM, Danville, Virginia.